But I got laid off the You could live by a lot of things in this world. So like I could give any advice is then it's just a simple advice of just love each other and have fun. Don't make such a fuss out of things, you know, like do something stupid. Do something really stupid. Get a tattoo. My name is Henk Schiefmacher, also known as Henky Panky. I live in Amsterdam, Holland. I tattoo since 1977, so like almost 40 years. Tattooing is my life. That's all I do. I wake up, make tattoos, talk tattoos, collect tattoos. That's all I do. I became a tattoo artist by accident. I was a young photographer, and I ran into this completely drunk man, and he had all these wonderful tattoos, and I took pictures of this man, and I immediately fell in love with the fact that this man had an extra form of communication. Normally people communicate with their hair, with their clothing, maybe with the jewelry, but this was an extra form, and it told all these different tales. A couple of friends of mine had a little basement in the red light district. And they say, Henk, you know how to tattoo? I go, yeah, well, yeah, I know how to tattoo. I thought a little bit. They said, well, the US Navy is coming into town with 6,000 GIs. Why don't you use the basement and try the tattoo? I thought, you know what? I'm going to give it a try. And I tattooed. And by the end of the weekend, I go, whoa. I had a nice bit of money. I had a lot of fun. I thought, like, I should do this a little bit more often. And that's where the thing sort of clicked. I said, you know, I should make a shop. And I actually married that thing. Sometimes I think I'm more married to tattooing than I ever was married to one of my wives. Until I married the last one who is fully tattooed. So now I have a tattooed wife as well. She's part of the collection, so like I don't worry. Oh, kleine jodeljongen. Every day there is a surprise in this business. Every day I do something, I go like, wow, or I go like, Jesus, that's stupid. It happened one day when the first rock and roll guy stepped into the shop, and that was Lemmy from Motorhead. So like I had my first tattoo celebrity, and then smaller groups of rock and roll people would start to frequent the shop. The Red Hot Chili Peppers, Pearl Jam, the people from the Bob Dylan bands. So it became all of a sudden like a rock, I was getting a rock star image out of this thing. In the 80s they were very, very young. They were not who they are today. So like very often they would actually stay at my home and Red Hot Chili Peppers sleep on the floor in the house. And that was a different bonding. Because there were 2 or 3 days in your house, you would tattoo them, you would eat together, you would drink together. So like that becomes a relationship. You have people from everywhere, in every country, every color. And the only thing we have in common is the fact that we have all this ink. So this becomes a sort of a religion in this world. I wanted to know where this phenomenon came from. So I traveled the whole world to look for the original forms of tattooing. Went into the jungles of Borneo, went to the Samoan people, went to the Maori people in New Zealand, and get tattooed by those people in those places. So these tattoos become a passport. They become stamps in your passport. They visas. They let you into these different worlds. When you get tattooed by somebody, you exchange something. There is a pain involved. There is a product. You have a piece of art from this person. So it's different than like buying a painting. The problem with painting or writing, I like to write too, that it's such an isolated type of thing. And here there is an interaction all the time with people. Your canvas walks away out of my museum. I don't have a fucking museum. My museum is out there. All these wonderful, beautiful young ladies, older men, everybody is tattooed by me. In 40 years, I tattooed this country.
That's why I sing the blues.